In their earliest experience of EDI-guided pressure support ventilation, Dr. Muttini and colleagues studied 10 acute respiratory failure patients ventilated over 96 hours with inspiratory pressure support titrated to obtain tidal volumes of 6 to 8 milliliters per kilogram predicted body weight and active inspiration. They compared the clinical pressure support setting with EDI-guided pressure support. Pressure support clinical levels were set according to the study by Tilla and colleagues in 2008. At the positioning, EDI peak value was always below 10 microvolts, with mean 5 microvolts. Respiratory rate was below 25 breaths per minute. Mean clinical pressure support was 12 centimeters of water. Decreasing the pressure support level with the aim to obtain a good and evident EDI signal, they discovered that pressure support levels were decreased by a mean value of 5 centimeters of water, with minor changes in tidal volume and respiratory rate.
Our need to improve assisted ventilation, avoiding overassistance and major asynchrony, and the need of weaning parameters became clear to us after experiencing EDI-guided pressure support. During the past 7 years, we have routinely treated over 400 patients in our ICU with EDI-guided pressure support and NAVA in acute respiratory failure patient as well as COPD patient in invasive ventilation and also non-invasive ventilation. We also use EDI to monitor the patients when they are disconnected from the ventilator. We feel that EDI is easy to implement and simple to use. We think that overassistance and asynchrony with pressure support ventilation are very frequent in the global intensive care community and leads to a greater morbidity. EDI is a true vital sign coming from our patient and give us very important information about patient-ventilator interaction. If you understand EDI, the ventilation mode NAVA is easy to use. Just as ECG became a vital sign of cardiology, let's try to use EDI as a respiratory vital sign for monitoring the adequacy of ventilatory support.
To find out more about ventilator-induced diaphragmatic dysfunction or EDI monitoring in NAVA, please refer to the selected list of publications or go to the criticalcarenews.com website.